Hey guys, welcome to Vlad's Art. Today we will try to attempt a close type terrarium using this vessel. So first what we will have to do is to have the substrate for this terrarium. I'm gonna use cocoa peat and then sand and moss. So like two parts of cocoa peat to one part of moss. This is our moss. It's a dried. It's a combination of sphagnum moss and fern moss. Since our terrarium is small, I'm just trying to estimate how much substrate it is that I am going to be using. But if you want to measure it out, you can have like two parts of the cocoa fiber and then to one part of the moss. You can, or it's recommended to use sphagnum moss, but if there isn't any place that you can get a sphagnum moss from, then you can opt in to use this kind of moss. Right, let's add in some charcoal. You can use any type of charcoal so long as it doesn't have any fuel in it. So it will be safe for use in a terrarium. Then here's sand. Since I'm not gonna layer it on the bottom, instead I'll put it in on the substrate. Thank you. our substrate is now done, and let's set it aside. Alright, the first that would go in is the false bottom. The first layer of our terrarium is the false bottom. You can use any pebble or small sized rocks. This is where the moisture would drain into if you are watering your plants. Here I'm using a lava rock. It's pulverized into small pieces. It's made up of lava rock on the sides. I want to use lava rock because it looks more natural with its color. Alright, so we're done with our substrate mixing, and I've lined our terrarium with small lava rocks. You can use any pebbles or small rocks, but I choose lava rock because the color is more natural and would match up to the things that I would later on add in this terrarium. So next step to this is that we would have to add a mesh. I will be using a cloth mesh. Gonna cut this into size. Let's see. Thank you. It is not really necessary that you would have to have a mesh, but it is recommended, so you won't have any problem in the future or in the long run, because this is the one that prevents any substrate to be mixed into your false bottom, and this helps a lot in the draining process of water into your false bottom from the substrate. So to hold it in place, you can first put in pebbles, or in my case, I'm putting lava rocks on the mesh before adding your substrate. So this is now how it looks like. I have the mesh in place and held together by the pebbles on the side. So we are now ready to put in our substrate. So earlier we had our substrate mixed. So I'm just gonna get a few of this and put it in. So this is how it's gonna be. Alright, so we'll be using some rocks. This is a dragon stone. And then I have here a few driftwoods. I hope this would fit in. Thank you. this one's going to be our tree. So I settled on this look, putting the rock on the center, then there's a driftwood. I'm hoping to achieve that it would look like some withered tree in the middle. I don't know. Alright, so the plants that we are going to be using are these. This is a spiky moss. It's a selaginella species. Then I have a few ferns here. These are very small ones. And then we'll be using different kind of moss as well. So. I'm trying to place the ferns on the side because when they grow they would be long and they would cover some moss if that's the case. I'm not really sure what's the name of this fern. but it could grow big. And then this one is known as coral fern from my country, but then it's a species of selaginella.
Yeah.